Welcome to the automation zone. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to handle your multiple web elements or a list of web element. Now, in our previous sessions, we have learned that a particular method called as find element is used to identify uniquely one web element only. In this case, I'm trying to identify a particular element by using the same method and by using the ID called as A. Now, if you look at the particular application, you would see that I basically have got two elements. This is the first element having the ID A, and I also have one more web element here having the ID A as well. So if I were to run this particular program, which value would it print? The first one, which is name A and ID A, or the second one, which is name B and ID A? Let me just go back to the program, save it and execute it. So again guys, here I'm trying to identify the element by using the method find web element, but the identifier is not unique. And if you see the output, it's basically trying to point out to the very first web element. So this is the very first thing that you should note. If you are trying to identify by using find web element and the identifier has got more than one web element, it is going to point or it is going to return your very first instance. So your get text over here will return only one value of your very first web element which is found. So how are you going to identify or how are you going to work with multiple web elements? Let us look at a different example. Here I have a website called as Mercury Tools, and here if you look at it, I've got many links. All of these links have got the tag called as your anchor tag, which is tag equal to A. So in this case, if I had to return or print the value of all of my links, it would be very tedious for me to do so. There's an easier way to do the exact same thing, and that is by using the method called as find web elements with an S. And this guys is not going to return for you one single web element, but it will return for you a list of web elements. For my friends who are new to Java, a quick note. When you are performing find web element without an S, you basically are returning a web element, and therefore you can perform click, get text or any other method on your web element. But when you are using the method find web elements with an S here, it is not returning for you a single web element but multiple web elements, and that too inside of a list. You cannot just perform click or get text on the list. Your first step is going to be to extract individual elements from the list, and then you perform your function on top of the web element. Now with that said, let us go back to our code here and write how to extract individual web elements from the list. Let us now make a few quick changes. We will not be navigating to this website but to the website Mercury Tools. And then what we'll do here is we are going to find, so driver.find web elements with an S, and we need to find all of the links. All of the links have got the same anchor tag called as A. Therefore, by the tag name, and since all the tags have an anchor tag, I can specify it by the letter A. So this here guys is going to return for me what? Is going to return for me a list of web elements. So our next step is going to be to save this list of web elements in a particular variable. Now if you do not know how to create a list, it is pretty simple. This is a list of web elements, right? So first step, you are creating a variable of web element. So how to do that? Web element, give a variable name, let the name be element, is equal to your particular code in Java. Now this here is a list. And this here guys is not a list, is a single web element. To convert a single variable to a list of the variable, you only have to type list right before the class. So web element here is a class, so I'm typing list right before the class, and I surround this particular class with these brackets like this. The moment I do this, your element here does not become a single element but becomes a list of elements. Let me give a better name for this, such as list of elements, so it makes more sense. Now if this list is not coming for you, it's mostly because the list here has not been imported. So if you are getting an error like this, you basically have to hover your mouse over it and import list from java.util, not from any other class, but from java.util package only. So just make a note of that. It has to be always from java util.list. Let me save this. So our next step is going to be to iterate to this list which is created. So to do that, you only have to do a for each loop. So for followed by your parentheses and then your brackets. In your parentheses, you have to specify which object or which variable you want to iterate. So I want to iterate this list of elements, which basically is a list of web elements. So you have to create a variable or you need to create an object of your web element. So web element, and let me give a name which makes sense, such as each link. The reason I'm giving this is because in each iteration, each web element over here or each link over here will be saved in this variable called as each link. You can call this a variable or you can call this an object of web element as well. Now this is run how many times? As many web elements are present inside of my list. And in each iteration, let me just do a print statement. And in my print statement, I'm going to perform the web element object dot get text. And in this way, I will be iterating to each of my link which is present on this website called as new tools. And then I will be printing all of the links in the console output right here. So let me save this and let me run it. And here we go. You can see the links of all of your the text of all of your links which is present on this web page right here is printed right here. Now the other thing which you can also do is remember last time in our very first session I told you that the class name is not used to identify something uniquely. So why is class used? So class is used usually by developers to give some common features to elements in your web page. Now if you look at all of these links here, mobile, bestsellers, computers, they all look the same. They also behave in the same manner. So if you just inspect on these elements right here, you notice that most probably they will be having the same class name as well. And this is true not only for the Amazon website, but any websites which you might encounter. So elements that have the same behavior, that look the same, usually might have the same class. And in this way, by specifying or identifying the element by using the class name, you can return all of the similar elements. So let us perform this as well by using the class name. So again, we'll make a few changes here. We will now navigate not to Mercury Tools but to Amazon.in. We will identify the elements not by the tag name but by the class name. And the class name is this one right here called as your nav. So let me copy this nav and let me paste it as an identifier right here. Just make sure to remove the spaces cause that is not allowed when you are identifying something by class. So once you're done with that, everything else will basically remain the same. So let me just save this and let me run this particular piece of code, and you would see that the text of all of your links will be printed in your console. Here we go. And these are all of your links. Now the other thing that you might have noticed is that here in my website you have got many links, but in your output you have only till pantry. The links after pantry are not being seen. This can also mean sometimes that your get text over here does not perform. And as we have learned earlier, you can either perform get text or you can perform dot get attribute. And any attribute you can type in text content. And this basically is going to return for you the text as well. So let me save this and let me run the exact same program, not by using a get text, but by using get attribute text content. And you notice that this time the code will work. Here we go. All of the links are being printed below. So guys, a quick note, how do you find out that no elements were found in your list? You simply have to do list.size, and this is going to return for you the total number of elements which are present inside of your list. So if the size is equal to 0, it means that no elements were found. So you can do that check, or you can simply check if the size is greater than 0 or not. Now with that said, all of this is very easily performed when you're using XParts. And the next tutorials are going to be on XParts, which I already have sorted out. We will be looking at the basics, the advanced, all of your functions as well, and we will be going through your XPath accesses as well. So do subscribe to my channel and stay tuned and get notified for these videos as well. If you have any questions in today's tutorial, do comment below, I will help you out. If you like the series on Selenium, do show your support by liking and sharing this video and subscribing to my channel. Thank you all guys for watching.